In this video, I'm going to show you how to digitally correct for any room coloration, as well as headphone coloration, using Sonarworks Reference 4. If this is your first time here and you want to learn all about FL Studio and music production in general, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell as well. If you're a typical bedroom producer, then I can almost guarantee that you're mixing in a less than optimal environment. That goes for headphone users as well, since many of the more popular headphones out there are not as flat as they should be when it comes to mixing. Recently, I did a review of the Sennheiser HD650. They are no doubt among the best sounding headphones you can get for the price, but they're not 100% flat, particularly in the low end, which I pointed out. You can find the link to the HD650 review down below. This will be the case with lots of headphones, and with Sonarworks Reference 4, you can compensate for that slight coloration, so you can get a really flat and neutral sound, which is the ideal thing for mixing. The interface is simple and very easy to use. In the upper right-hand corner, you can choose between headphones or monitors. I'll get to monitors in a bit, but let's have a look at headphones first. As you can see, there's a huge list of headphones to choose from, including many from Sennheiser. There's the HD650. This is the frequency response after the correction has been applied. You can show additional parameters here. If I enable before, then you can see the frequency response before correction. As you can see, the low end is a bit amplified, and you don't want that when mixing. You can easily turn the correction on and off here. It's quite amazing how much of a difference this makes. It's like night and day, actually. I can now have peace of mind when using these headphones for mixing, not having to constantly correct for any low-end coloration manually. Awesome! Now, let's move on to monitors. This is a bit more complicated, but not much. Even with acoustic treatment, a typical bedroom studio will never be as good as a professional studio. The room will typically be too small, too squared, and the sound will bounce all over the place. The good news is that Reference 4 can compensate for this as well. I generally always recommend mixing on monitors rather than headphones, simply because there's a lot of issues involved with mixing on headphones, as I explained in my headphones versus monitors video. Check out the link below if you want to know more about that. Room coloration is a big problem when mixing on monitors, though, and the monitors themselves will often color the sound too, especially budget monitors. In order to compensate for this, Sonarworks Reference 4 will do a series of extremely precise measurements of your room acoustics. This is done using a special microphone. The measurement is so delicate that each microphone is actually individually calibrated. When you hook it up, you need to type in the serial number of your microphone, and then it will load the calibration for that particular microphone from a database. You can, in theory, use a standard microphone, but the measurement won't be as precise, so I strongly recommend using the specially designed microphone for this. To do this, we need to set up a new profile, then follow the instructions on the screen. During the calibration process, you'll have to hold the mic in various positions. It might sound a bit complicated, but it's really not. Just follow the instructions on the screen, and you'll be fine. This takes about 20 minutes.
Stay where you are. Measurements in progress.
Save the profile when you're done. You can now open Sonarworks Reference 4 in your DAW. Make sure to load it on the last effects slot on the master channel. Click on the monitor icon and open the profile you just saved. If I turn it on, you can now see the corrections it made. My studio is actually acoustically treated, but there are still some issues here, especially in the low end. Acoustic foam tends to work very well on mid and high frequencies, but the low end is more problematic. As you can see, there are differences between the left and right monitors, too. This has to do with the shape of the room and what's in it, like doors, windows, and so on. The software will correct for this, and the result is a much cleaner, flatter, or truer representation of the sound. This means that you can now place more confidence in the way your mix sounds. You're probably used to doing the car test and testing the mix in various locations, which is a smart thing to do, and you have no doubt noticed that it sounds very different every time. If you mix in a professional studio, which is acoustically optimized with minimum coloration and with top-notch gear, then you can be confident that if the mix sounds clean and balanced in that room, then it should translate well to various other systems and locations as well. So the car test shouldn't really be necessary. However, in a typical bedroom studio and with cheaper monitors, you can't always trust what you hear is a true representation of your mix. Reference 4 is a great tool in that regard. The before and after result speaks for itself. It won't magically transform your bedroom studio into a professional studio, but it will compensate for a lot of the coloration that typically occurs. That will make your mix sound more transparent, which should enable you to mix with more confidence. In short, this plugin can make life as a music producer a whole lot easier. If you want to check out this plugin yourself, then you can find the links in the description below. Note that there are two versions to choose from. If you mix exclusively on headphones, then you only need the headphone edition. The microphone has to be purchased separately, and I strongly recommend that you get it in order to get the best possible result when mixing on monitors. I'd like to thank our Patreons for their ongoing support, and as always, if there's any specific tutorial you'd like us to make, or if you have a question, just let us know in the comments below. Also, make sure to check out the links below if you need feedback on your music, mastering, and so on. Thanks for watching.